The most important thing to know about the Systems to Win tools for Domaic Six Sigma is that they are designed to supplement, not replace, statistical software. There are already many good statistics software applications to choose from, all the way from inexpensive Excel add-ins to Minitab. The Systems to Win templates are designed to fill in the holes, because every one of those statistics applications has some non-statistical things that it does very poorly. The Systems to Win templates provide things like a SIPOC worksheet to clarify boundaries and better understand everything that goes into and out of a process. Failure modes and effects analysis to identify, anticipate, and eliminate possible quality problems. Root cause analysis to dig out your root problems rather than hacking at the leaves. Pareto analysis to identify those 20% of your problems that cause 80% of your grief. Collecting voice of the customer data and translating your customers' sometimes less than fully clear words into hard measurable criteria that your engineers can understand. Cause and effects matrix, Kano analysis, and a quality functional deployment matrix to decide what is and is not worth doing, and to design new and existing products to meet your customers' real desires. And several tools to avoid the single most common and most costly mistake made by so many new and even experienced Six Sigma teams: selecting the wrong things to measure in the first place. Your Systems to Win Domaic Six Sigma Toolkit comes with pretty much all of the non-statistical tools that you read about in all those Six Sigma books or learn about in your Green Belt or Black Belt training. A good place to start is with the SIPOC diagram. Since the SIPOC has its own training video, we won't duplicate that training here. We also won't duplicate the training for the features that come with every Systems to Win template. Once you've used the SIPOC tool to get a clear understanding of a process, one of the most cost-effective things you can do to improve quality of that process is to begin using a failure modes and effects analysis worksheet, which also has its own training video. The Ishikawa root cause analysis fishbone diagram is an immensely powerful tool to identify root problems and stimulate ideas for solving them. The primary shortcoming of Lean and Kaizen methods is that people rush into solving problems before they have adequately defined the problems, and as a result end up hacking away at the leaves rather than at the roots. And as any gardener knows, sometimes pruning a bush just makes it come back even thicker and stronger than it was before you pruned it back. While the root cause analysis fishbone diagram is the right tool for getting to the root causes underlying a well-defined problem, the thought map relations diagram is the right tool to make sense of the root causes underlying a complex, messy tangle of interrelated problems. You use the customer segmentation worksheet to identify the customer segments and perhaps subsegments for each product family, and then to prioritize which segments are most worthy of your attention. Voice of the Customer Data Collection is a simple word form that provides excellent online training at the click of a mouse at the moment that the training is actually about to be needed, to remind your people of all those things they read about in all those books that they left at home somewhere. And then prompts your people to simply fill in the blanks to determine the appropriate levels of filtering and sorting criteria for the existing customer information that might already exist buried somewhere in your company's various data repositories, and the current and possible new customer listening posts that might be worth monitoring to keep your collective ears to the ground to listen to what your customers keep trying to tell you in their verbal and nonverbal ways, and what indirect research might be done through libraries, industry trade publications, market analyses, industry experts, and whatnot. And as a very last resort, if there's absolutely no way around it, perhaps to resolve to do some expensive and time-consuming surveys or focus groups or other forms of direct research. Before we leave this template, we should point out that as a free service, every one of your Systems to Win Word and Excel templates comes personalized with your own company logo. After collecting your voice of the customer data, the next step is to translate potentially vague customer comments into functional requirements that your engineers can understand and measure, thereby strengthening your team's ability to design and deliver products and services that truly delight your customers. Your voice of the customer requirements and their corresponding engineering functional requirements can then be used as the starting point for building a house of quality, which is also known as a quality functional deployment matrix. Rather than doing all of the thorough analyses of the QFD, the cause and effect matrix is used to identify those few process input variables that provide the greatest opportunity to improve your key process outputs, or things your customers care about. It's a simpler way of answering a similar question. Where should we focus our attention? The Critical to Quality Tree Diagram, Measurement Selection Worksheet, and Measurement Assessment Tree Diagram are all tools designed to help you avoid the single most common and single most costly mistake made by so many Six Sigma teams, choosing the wrong measures. Nothing is quite so discouraging as spending 3 months collecting expensive and time-consuming data and then finally sitting down with your team to analyze that data, only to realize that you really needed a little more stratification detail, or you really need this other data too. And then you either have to start the process all over again, or you make the decision to be sloppy and just make educated guesses, which defy the entire philosophy and power of Six Sigma method of quality improvement in the first place. All the statistical analysis in the world isn't going to do you any good if you're analyzing the wrong data in the first place. The Operational Definitions Worksheet is used to ensure that everyone collecting data collects it in a consistent way. Jack asks the questions in the same way as Jill, and an identical customer response gets interpreted in the same way by both Jack and Jill, thereby avoiding the common problem of investing all that time and money to do a costly customer survey and then trying to mix apples and oranges because Jack conducted and interpreted his survey in a way that was completely different from the way Jill conducted and interpreted the same survey. Although Systems to Win templates don't do any statistics themselves, what we do provide is a convenient way to organize your data to make it easier to use and to get more value from any statistical software. Every single person in your license group can now create a Pareto chart of any of their data. And the more you use this, the more addicted you'll become to charting things. The Six Sigma Team Roles handout is designed to be personalized by your Six Sigma team leaders to clearly define the responsibilities of each role in your company. See this red paragraph there? If that paragraph has not yet been deleted, that means you're looking at the unedited starting template, which then needs to be personalized by your own company to define the way your Six Sigma teams are organized in your company. The Empowerment Boundaries is a simple one-page document that's designed to be framed and hung on a wall somewhere to clarify your management's decisions regarding what your Six Sigma teams are and are not empowered to do. And we even give you a fill-in-the-blanks Six Sigma project charter, specially designed to fit nicely within a PowerPoint slide. And of course, Systems to Win also offers several other bundles of templates for continuous improvement, using methods that can greatly complement DMAIC Six Sigma methods. You might add some other bundles of templates after you have become delighted with the Six Sigma tools, or you can earn substantial savings by purchasing multiple bundles on a single invoice. So there you have it. A full suite of non-statistical tools for DMAIC Six Sigma quality improvement, all written using the software that you already know and are comfortable using, Microsoft Word and Excel. The people that will most appreciate what they've just seen are the highest level black belts and master black belts who've already spent many evenings working late away from their families trying to recreate homemade templates. In fact, the most common comment that we hear in our live demos is, "We've already created some of these." And our response is, "How could anyone do any kind of Six Sigma project without inventing some sort of tools to do these things?" The question your executive team should be asking is not, "Have you already invented some homemade tools to do some of these things?" but, number one, do any of your homemade tools approach the quality of what you've seen here? With pop-up help, sample help, online training, macros, professional attention to subtle details, consistent user interface, and all the attention to making the templates easy to use. And number two, have you already invested the weeks of full-time effort that it would take to develop something close to this entire suite of tools? And number three, how many of your high-value Six Sigma black belts are spending how much of their payroll hours inventing and reinventing their own favorite versions of similar tools? At what point might it make some sense to standardize? And even if you had already invested all of that sunk cost into developing an entire suite of tools and done a good job of it, what about future continuous improvement? If you've gone through all that training to be a Six Sigma black belt, then you're a very valuable asset to your company, aren't you? After your CFO sits you down for a refresher discussion on the importance of making intelligent make or buy decisions, you need to be prepared to answer his or her pointed question. What are you thinking? Why would a company encourage its highest paid black belts to devote their precious time to attempt to recreate tools that could be purchased so easily? Tools written in generic Word and Excel that can then be personalized so easily if needed, making just a few personalizations to an already complete and professional tool, rather than starting with a blank worksheet. Fill in the blanks, Word and Excel templates, duplicating the best of the non-statistical tools found in all the DMAIC Six Sigma teachings, with plenty of helpful online training always just one click away. That's what you get when you choose to use the Systems to Win templates for DMAIC Six Sigma. Thank you for visiting, and perhaps for being a valued customer of Systems to Win, where our mission is to help you continuously improve your tools for continuous improvement.